Oh boy.
Oh, father, father!
The bishop is down. How are we gonna get married now? We have no priest.
One of them is gonna have to do it.
They can't, they're not priests, honey.
I came all the way here for nothing. What are we gonna do?
I can do it.
But sir, you're not a priest, how could you?
You have to, right now, I don't care. Do it.
I have special consent from the Pope.
Wow. No, that checks out.
In certain circumstances, people from the crowd can marry people like you.
Whatever, man. I believe you.
On this pretty neat day, we have Luke and Daniela made for holy matrimony. How you feeling today?
Pretty well.
Feeling okay.
Excuse me. Move over, please. I can't see.
At this time, I'll ask you, Luke, and you, Daniela, to face each other. Take each other's hands.
You're gonna have to move back, right? How does that feel?
Luke, will you take Daniela to be your wife, your partner in life, and your one true love?
Great.
Will you cherish her friendship and love her today, tomorrow, and forever? Will you trust and honor her, laugh with her, cry with her? Will you just look at her? Will you be faithful through good times and bad, in sickness and in health, as long as she'll both live?
I do.
Daniela, will you take Luke to be your husband, your partner in life, and your one true love? Will you cherish his friendship and love him today, tomorrow, and forever? Will you trust and honor him, laugh with him, and cry with him? Will you be faithful through good times and bad, in sickness and in health, as long as you both live?
I do.
Well, I now ask you two both to exchange the rings.
Can I get my ring?
I hope you guys remembered them.
I love this woman.
Comment,
ladies and gentlemen, it's beautiful.
He went to Jared.
He went to Jared!
24 karat gold, ladies and gentlemen, 24 karat gold.
You may now kiss the bride. We're joining back here at the Channel 4 News Team Station after the Huff and Dobek wedding. Oh my god, it was just... brought a tear in my eye. In the whole marriage is the communion of spouses, but not only that, it's a communion in Christ, a family communion, a communion with the church, and lastly, a communion with society. Family also has to be open to new life in the sanctity of marriage, which means they can't be against abortions, contraceptions, you know what I mean by that. They have to be open to the natural family planning, which is the church-approved method for regulating birth and marriage in accord with God's will. And by having these little children, they will have the family grow together and in one, by the faith of God, grow as family and grow in the faith of God. What's that? I have Brian and Brendan in the field with the happy couple. Brian.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have found the groom of the wedding.
How you doing?
Mr. Luke. How does it feel to be a married man? It
feels awesome. I'm going to love my wife with every ounce of love that I have in my heart.
There's just so much love.
So much love.
So much love, ladies and gentlemen. So what are your plans with your new wife?
We're going to start a family and have three kids.
Three, very odd numbers, ladies and gentlemen. Odd numbers. What do you think about becoming a married man in the Catholic church.
It's the best way to do it. It's the best way to do it. That's all I can say.
And that just sums it up for you, ladies and gentlemen. I am Brian Fantana reporting in the field at the royal wedding. Thank you. Have a good day. Back to you.
All right, guys. I'm here with Danny, Daniella. I managed to hunt her down. She's looking very gorgeous today, though. I have to say.
Well,
I have
thank
to
you.
Say. That flower's very complimentary to your eyes.
It was my mother's.
It was?
Yep.
I doubt that, but, how do you feel after such an event that everyone wants to know, and don't grab the mic for me, please. How do you feel? Hands at your side, miss, please.
All right.
Mrs. Oh, I'm sorry. You just got married.
That's correct.
Go ahead.
I just know that it's true love, and I'm so happy. I mean,
you seem happy by the way you laugh. And
yeah,
smile.
That's a happy
you
laugh.
You seem
all right.
Really happy.
Well,
wow.
Well, see, me and Luke fell in love back in high school. He asked me out after the homecoming game, and I.
All right, we don't really need the story. We just need you to tell me how you feel.
Okay. Well, I feel really happy. Feel like it's true love. I feel like I married the man.
We all know it's true love because it has to be. In the Catholic faith, you have to be married. Has to be true love, okay?
Oh, that's correct.
We all know that. You don't have to tell me that.
You're right.
After such a momentous event in your life, Danny.
Danielle.
After hearing those deep, very deep and personal vows, those promises between the man and the woman, do you plan to keep faith? It's kind of hard in this society, but do you plan to stay faithful?
Oh, I sure do. You know, I love Luke. I mean, he's the only man I'm really attracted to. You know, that's why I married him. So it's not going to be very hard to be faithful, okay? You know, I'm just going to be the best wife I can be. I'm sure going to be faithful, though. That's for heck darn it, that's for sure, okay?
That's actually hard to believe, though, because of that. You're just overwhelming beauty.
Well,
And you look kind of promiscuous, frankly. I don't know what else. I don't know how else to put it. You kind of do. Are you sure you're going to stay faithful, sir?
Let me answer that. Well, you know, I am. I'm not going to lie. I think God did bestow some great gifts upon me with my beauty. I do believe I'm a pretty girl, yes. And I think that's what their track loops, along with my other great features. But, yes, I don't think I'm going to go out and, you know, do anything wrong. I love him so much. So dearly. And it might be hard. Other men might be attracted to me, of course. But I think I'll be able to handle
it. Right. Well, that is staying true to the Catholic faith. I commend you for that.
Thank you so much.
That's kind of hard to do, but I'm signing out now. See you later. We'll.
All right. Well, we're here at the Channel 4 News team, and guys, how'd you feel about that wedding?
Brian Fantana, felt this was beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, that was one of the most excellent weddings between a man and a definite woman. Definite woman.
Definitely a woman. Had to have been in the Catholic Church. It has to be a woman. Can't be a man.
I mean,
cannot be man on man.
The Catholic Church definitely. The Pope clearly sent us a letter saying that it was okay.
It was okay.
For the lay people in the stands. Yes, the stands. To come forth.
Exactly.
Come hither and marry.
I'm glad it happened. They look really happy together. I hope nothing happens.
So much love.
Something along the lines of adultery or polygamy.
Polygamy, sir. Because then they'll need a declaration of nullity.
Can you reflect on what polygamy is?
Well, that would be. Correct me if I'm wrong, but the marriage between a man and either two or more women, right?
Yes, that's true.
Yeah, and that would just
such a disgrace.
At the
Mormons do that actually. The Mormons used to do that until they said no, can't do that anymore.
Right. Well, in other cases, also we all know a declaration of nullity.
Yeah.
Could be enforced where that's the church saying that the marriage never existed. But you know, we hope that
that's the only
doesn't.
Way you could divorce, folks. If you didn't know. If you're trying to divorce other ways, no.
Also,
you're not Catholic then. You're really not.
For all those lucky men out there, in the unfortunate event that they have to get married again. They got married in church the first time. They can't get married in church again. It's against God's laws.
Wow. I actually didn't know that.
Unless the church does permit the declaration of nullity, which would make the marriage invalid.
therefore, ladies and gentlemen, allowing them to be married in a church.
Right. But that's not what we're talking about.
Not at all. Thank you.
All right, and finally, we're going to conclude today's just pure understanding of marriage. It's hard not to get choked up, and honestly, it is. Today, we're going to conclude with an interview with a man we all truly love and respect, who's been married for many, many years. Frank Alcala, everybody.
Beautiful man. Slim. Quick.
Come on. Gentlemen, what brings you to my office this afternoon?
We'll be conducting an interview for you today about your relationship with your marriage.
Well, that's just my favorite topic.
There we go.
Alright, I'm just gonna go with a shot out of the cannon right now.
You go for it. Throw those questions right out.
How long have you been married?
This year, I will be married to my lovely wife 25 years.
Mazel tov.
Yes.
One quarter. There you go.
Yes, quarter of 100. That's it. Loved every minute of it.
Good luck in your future endeavors.
Thank you. As a matter of fact, June 12th, we will be celebrating with a mass down at the National Cathedral, in Newark.
There you go. A Catholic family man.
Yes, very much so.
Beautiful. Next question.
Okay, well, question number two for the day. How did you and your wife meet up?
My wife and I met. Actually, we're high school sweethearts. We met at a summer job at Bradley's in Wayne.
There you go.
She was 17. I was a little older, and we've been together ever since.
Lovely.
Thanks to my head.
Lovely.
Were you married in a church?
We were both married in the church. Yes, we were married at Our Lady of Mount Carmel Church in Ridgewood.
Ah. Nice.
By a family friend, Monsignor Francis Houghton, who's known me, he's known my father since they were children, and performs all our baptisms and weddings, funerals, unfortunately.
Family sacraments.
Family stuff.
Just love it.
So, do you consider your family to be a family with God?
Yes, very much so. Not just because we go to church and pray, but God is a very important part of all of our lives. From the onset when my wife and I met, when I first ran into her in the store, in Bradley's, she had a glow about her, honestly. And I actually called my parents and told them to come down to the store. I was going to show them the girl I was going to marry. And they came to the store.
That's beautiful.
And I married.
There you go.
Of course, I was a stalker, but
aren't we all?
Thank God they didn't have those
Facebook these
time.
Days, you know?
Yes.
Well,
I'm impressed. We can only hope to one day be like Frank the Tank.
Frank. It's wonderful.
Man. Thanks a lot, Mr. Alcaro. You're a big help. I know you're watching right now, so thank you. That's all the people we have to interview today, so...
It was truly beautiful.
For all of us here at the Channel 4 News team, including TJ Sancetta, who is not part of this production, but he was the fainting priest, salutations.
I'm Justin McKenzie.
And stay classy, Ojo's class.